Hey everybody, I'm back to show you something else. This is the Unreal 4K Action Cam. I picked this up on Amazon. It goes for $59.99. As of this recording, there is a 10% coupon if you go buy it off of Amazon right now. This features about 2.45 inch touchscreen, and it has a wide angle 170 degree lens on the front, and it is waterproof and offers many recording modes. You can record at 4K, 24 frames per second, 2K at 30 frames per second, 1080p at 60 or 30 frames per second, and then there's some lower resolution ones that no one cares about anymore, so we can skip that. It can take photos up to 16 megapixels, and it also does a time lapse, okay? Does this support a micro SD card up to 64 gigs? It comes with the remote and all that, but enough talking. Let's open this up and see what it is like. Wow, look at this. This is amazing. Look at this presentation for you. It's like you're unwrapping something beautiful, and it just brings you so much more excitement. Look at this. This is amazing. So right here you have the USB-A to micro USB charging adapter and data cable. So I'll set that aside because everybody knows what that looks like. Next to that is this. So this is basically a rechargeable remote. So there you see there's a micro SD slot right there. You can charge this up and control the camera from here. You can turn the display on and off. You can hit record and other options. So there's three set buttons right here for you to control the camera. So let me put that aside. And let's get to the camera itself. Look at this. Look how beautiful this looks. It's already in its waterproof casing. You can see there's a shutter button right on top. Huge display, because it's basically the display is the size of the entire back of this thing. There is a mount point right here, and you know GoPro users will be familiar with this. This is how you mount this to anything. Slide this over, it comes right off. So here's one change from the GoPros. You don't just pull it off, you slide it. And then it easily comes right off, because one of the problems with the GoPros I have is trying to grab it to take it off because it's so tight, I feel like my nails are gonna fall off. So once you have that, you can rip the front off and the camera comes right out. So this thing is small. Look at this. This is like really small, but it feels somewhat heavy, which means like it's really packed with features and the build quality is really good. Like if I didn't do this, I wouldn't know it's plastic, but because it almost looks and feels like metal. What's over here? You get some charging cables. So there's where the micro SD adapter goes in, and it's pretty minimalistic. There's no mic input. But for those of us that have an external mic, shouldn't be a problem. You see there's a, well, I accidentally turned it on, but you see there is a battery. So it's 1100 milliamp hour battery. All right, looks like this. And on the side is the micro SD slot. So this is similar to the GoPro design. All right, let me go ahead and pop this baby back in, put this in, close it. This is really one button operation. So if I hold this, let me try. It turns on and there it is. Let's take a closer look at the menu system though. All right, here it is. And as you can see, I am in normal video mode, 4K, 24 frames per second. All right, so to get into the settings, you want to just give it a tap. And from there, you can see all the various options. Burst mode, you want it off, burst 3 or burst 5,
or 10. So set it at 3. Resolution, is it full 16 megapixels or 14, 12, 10, 8, 5, 3, all the way down to VGA? Thank you for offering it, but no thank you. We want the highest resolution, so we'll leave it at that. Field of view, there's I think there's three settings. There's wide, there's medium, and there's narrow. So how much do you want to capture, right? So it's currently set to wide. We'll leave it at that for now. There's the date stamp. Do you want it on or off? We can leave it on for now. Quality, economy, normal, or fine? We're going fine, baby. Sharpness, normal. White balance, auto. Color, normal. ISO, set to auto, but you can see you can change it yourself up to 1600. So I'll leave it at auto for now. The exposure, you can change it as well. So I'll just hit back, go to the next setting, power on mode. You can leave it on the last mode that it was on, normal video or time lapse or slow motion, video photo, car mode, so it can act as a car cam. Water mode, normal photo, there's so many, photo lapse sequence, there's so many to choose from. Record on, power on record. So you can choose that, the date and the time. Language, lots of languages to choose from. The beeping sound can be turned off because that can be annoying if you're at like a recital or something and everyone's looking at you. There's the frequency, you can change 50 to between 50 and 60. Fisheye setting, on or off. Screensaver mode, within 3 minutes. Image rotation, if you turn it upside down or something, you can. It'll probably do it for you. You can format the card if you have one. I don't have a card inside yet. You can change to default settings. See the version of your firmware right here. I'm on V1 from 2018. Okay.
All right, let's just see what else is in this box. Ooh, here's a user manual. Here's a screen wiping cloth or lens wiping cloth and a bunch of accessories. So here's one to attach it to your bicycle or scooter or something like that. You see how it's round? It'll go around a cylinder perfectly. A much appreciated extra battery right there. Thank you. You have some more adapters right here with 3M tape. You have this, which attaches to the base of the waterproof container so that you can attach it to other things. You have this. And you have some more double-sided tape pieces right there. And you also have this nut as well that can go on the bottom without the case.
This is an audio test. I'm 2 feet away from the camera, speaking normally. Test. ABC, 1, 2, 3, test. This is an audio test.